In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create this 3D blob morph effect in Adobe Illustrator. Stay tuned to find out.
Studio Shepherd.
So we're going to start by selecting the ellipse tool and holding shift, I'm going to draw out a circle, and then I'm going to draw out a smaller circle just above it. Now select both of your circles and we're going to right click and make compound path. After that, go up to effect, down to path and select offset path. And here I'm going to bump up the offset to around 30 so that our two shapes are now touching. And I'm going to change the joins to round, then press OK. Now again, go up to effect, down to path, offset path. This time we're going to apply a new effect and I'm going to have the offset set to negative 30 and the join set to round, then press OK. And now you can see it's creating this morphing effect between our two shapes. We can drag this round by selecting the white arrow tool. And I'm going to select the smaller circle, making sure we haven't selected any of this circle. So I'm going to hold shift and click this path here to deselect it. And then clicking one of these anchor points, we can drag it round and it creates this live morphing effect, which is really fun to play with. And don't ask me how this is working, it just does. So after that, we want to make our shape 3D. So select it, and we're going to go up to Effect, down to 3D Materials, Extrude and Bevel. And here, if we scroll right down, we're going to adjust the rotation. So I'm going to change all of these values to 0. Now if we scroll up, we're going to enable bevel. I'm going to change the bevel shape to round. And here we can play around with the width and the height of our shape. After that, you can also play around with the lighting if you want to make it more intense or less intense and adjust any of these other values. Now the cool thing is, once you've done this, we can double click and select either of our circles, and holding Alt, we can click and drag to make a copy, which has the same effect applied to it. And then we can drag this around and add to our shape. Once you've done this, if we double click to exit our compound path, select your shape again, and then in the top right here, we can click this drop down to activate our render settings. And I'm going to enable ray tracing. And you can select low, medium, or high quality, and then click render, and you'll end up with a result like this. And that's how to create a 3D blob morph effect in Adobe Illustrator.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.